Welcome back to Let's Play Beyond Skyrim. Bruma, blind. I'm the RPG chick, finally entering Bruma, here with Scruffy and Carlia. You're cold. The fire's up there, though. God, right in my face all the time. We gotta find him either a new owner or his old owner. I don't want to relinquish him to the old owner. Unless we can find out, you know, talk to him and find out, well, where the, all the bruises and the patches of fur missing come from. How you doing?
Protect and serve. It's what we do.
Well, good for you. Just good for you. Hiya. Realte?
Please, madam. Just one septim.
What made you a beggar?
A series of unlucky events. I'd rather not talk about it.
Figured you'd want to head south. Here, have a coin.
My most sincere thanks, honored friend.
Here, have another one.
Bless you, madam. Bless you. Until next time.
Until the... So this is Bruma. So far looks
Hail,
like...
Hail, friend.
Hi. Why, hello there.
Yes, dearie.
Dearie?
Have you come to learn or just to bother an old collector?
Alright. She's probably not as old-looking as she should be, because I have this mod installed that makes the females more attractive. Smooths out the wrinkles and stuff. You're a collector of artifacts?
Oh, absolutely. I collect anything Nordic, whether it be a crafted artifact or a spoken story.
Hmm.
Some may call it an odd hobby, but I'm proud to preserve my people's ancestry.
Okay. Where does the name Silver Plow come from?
Ah, an interesting question, with an interesting tale to follow.
I'm sure you'll tell me.
You see, the names of Nordic clans are earned. Not simply given. Each name has a meaning, each meaning a story.
Indeed.
Our clan was once a small group of farmers in Windhelm, in an era long before this one.
Very familiar with the place.
We were a poor lot, and could barely pull enough roots out of the ground to make a living.
Hmm.
But one among our clan, an exceptionally bright young man, had a plan to help us till the icy soil of the north. He left the farm and traveled to Whiterun to learn from the best smiths in the province. He studied there for many years before returning.
To make a till?
He brought with him a plow of tempered steel so bright and gleaming that it shone like pure silver in the sunlight. The metal was tough and sharp enough to tear through the frosty earth, and light enough to be carried by even the lamest of ponies. The farm and the clan, my clan, flourished, and was thereafter known as Silver Plow. It just goes to show that not all great clans and warriors survive by tackling their problems head on. Sometimes
true.
You've got to use your brain more than your blade.
That's very true. Oh god. That was a good tale. I praise your clan's cunning.
Why, you honor me with your compliments. Thank you, thank you. Come back any time for more lore or history.
Sure. This looks like shrugs and just walks off. Okay. Wow, where do I go first? Oh god, this dog. Let's go this way. Anyone need a dog? Well, that's silver plows from there. All right. How you doing?
Our silver plow.
Oh.
Retired hunter and tracker at your service.
I just met your wife or something.
Saw a beautiful stag the other day. Should have got my bow and went after it.
Hmm. You're a hunter?
Used to be, yes.
Oh, yeah, retired.
I hunted game all over County Bruma. From the Geralds to the Vallis and the South into Coral. Bagged some pretty impressive beasts in my day. Mm. Say, would you like to hear about the time I killed the most monstrous grizzly in all of Cyrodiil?
Sure.
I was out for a normal trek into the wild, and I found these tracks you see.
Uh-huh.
They weren't any ordinary tracks either. They were big, huge, larger than any bear print I had ever seen before, or since.
Go on.
I knew it was foolish to chase after such a monster, especially with the snow coming down as hard as it was.
But
I just thought of how beautiful its head would look, mounted over my mantle, and I pressed on.
That's rock.
It found me on the slopes of Dive Rock, galloping from a copse of trees, faster than an avalanche. Its roar louder than thunder.
Oh my.
I didn't have time to put an arrow into his heart. I dropped my bow, pulled out my axe, and danced with the beast on that mountain.
Oh boy.
Fortunately, such a creature is not well suited for hunting on the steep crags of the Geralds. After a little tussle, I sent the beast tumbling off the cliff to its death.
Oh.
Took me nearly a week to find, clean, and haul the carcass back to Bruma. Now it sits above the fire.
Pardon me.
A proper trophy.
Hmm. That's impressive. Well, they really give you a lot of chances to be a complete jerk, don't they?
Thank you. Thank you. I invite you to stop by my home any time to see the beast.
Would you like a dog?
But mind the wife. One wrong word and she'll talk your ear off about something or other.
We've met.
Not all of us can be proper, though, I suppose.
Oh. You don't talk a lot either. I have a chance to ask him to tell me again. Your wife. You're a married man?
Aye, that I am. Married in the true Nord way to my wife, Felki.
Is that her name?
She might be a little talkative sometimes, what with all her stories of myths and nonsense and whatnot. But she is a good woman.
Yeah, it seems like it.
At least I'm not like that, eh?
What, a good woman? No, you're not a good woman. What's the word around town?
Lots of refugees coming in from Skyrim.
Hmm.
Civil war is getting pretty nasty, I hear.
Hmm. It was capitalized. Any more word around town?
There's some bard down at the tavern playing a real awful racket. Hope he leaves soon, or we might just have to run him out of town.
Hmm.
See you around.
Take my dog, please. I'm welcome anytime. Your door's locked. Who are we supposed to turn him into? Hold on. Yeah, not that. Right, search for the missing horse. North of Bruma Stables, bring Scruffy to Banus or find him a new home. And all the other stuff is leftover stuff from Skyrim or bugged out quests I can't finish. Talk to the companions, leader for work I think never goes away? I'm not sure. Hello? Look, this dog looks right at home. Do you want this dog? You want the dog. I know you want the dog.
Hello?
Hi.
Excuse me, but have you ever heard of the champion of Cyrodiil?
The champion of Cyrodiil? Is that the character, the main character, of Oblivion? Of course, the champion aided Martin in saving the word from Maroon's Dagon.
Yes, indeed. And my great, 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 great... Well, anyway, my very, very distant grandfather. He fought alongside the champion. He was at the Battle of Bruma. He was the captain of the guard, no less.
Wow. You won. How interesting.
The champion is my inspiration, second only to Captain Bird. You know, the distant relative. I have a very large collection of Champion of Cyrodiil artifacts, my pride and joy, and I always want to expand it. Perhaps one day you'll aid me in that pursuit, huh? But that day isn't today. I need to track down another artifact first.
Do you?
Anyway, thank you for your time, and sorry for approaching you so abruptly. Sometimes my passion for the champion can carry me away. Sorry again.
Get the feeling these people are rather lonely.
Excuse me, but have you ever heard of the Champion of Cyrodiil?
Okay.
I understand. Probably very busy.
Oh. Why do you have a skeleton? Is this the champion's... Is this the champion's hand? You have it a master lock there? What is all this stuff? That looks like manacles. Okay. Oh, I can read this? Museum pa- This dog is making some strange sounds. The Hall of the Champion. The Museum for the Champion of Cyrodiil is open every day from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. except on Sundays when it's closed early at 6 p.m. Come and see the wondrous artifacts of the champion. Entry is free, while special exclusive tours cost only 20 septims, 10 for children and the elderly. Oh, nice. Harold Birdson. Visit the Hall of the Champion, aren't I here? Well, that finished it? Oh, I can't move.
Hello?
Oh, now I can ask him about... Why did you open this museum? I know it's a stupid question.
Well, the Champion of Cyrodiil saved the entire world. Why not revere him?
Hmm. Why do you need Birdson? I know, because you're the son of Captain Bird, I think his name was?
Well, my great-great-great-great... my ancestor, Bird, fought alongside the Champion of Cyrodiil during the Battle of Bruma. The first Birdson was born after Bird's death.
Hmm.
Given his fame and status as Captain of the Guard, he felt he was worthy of making a name. It's been that way for generations.
Mm-hmm. What do you have for sale?
Have a browse. Let me know if you like what you see.
Suppose you'd be interested in any staves? No. Yeah, he only selling the stamina potion and at better prices? Doesn't look like he buys staves. Would you like a, I don't know. Would you be interested in an Elder Scroll? Yeah, maybe not. Then I'm here to see the museum.
Welcome to the Hall of the Champion, the only museum of the Champion of Cyrodiil in the Imperial Province. While some call it a place of learning, I imagine it as an altar to the champion's greatness.
Okay.
I offer exclusive tours of the museum with thrilling explanations of the significance of each artifact.
Yeah, I want to know what this hand
is. 20 septims for a fantastical retelling of the champion's exploits.
You sure? Yeah, sure. I'd like the exclusive tour then.
Thank you for your contribution. Now please, follow me.
Okay. Lead the way. Is the dog in the way? He does that. Ugh. Where are you trying to go? Ooh, Guide to Bruma, first edition.
Oh, goody, you're in for a treat. Our tour begins with the prison.
Manacles? Mm.
The champion of Cyrodiil was discovered by His Imperial Majesty Uriel Septim the Seventh in the Imperial Dungeon. These are the manacles which the champion wore. A priceless artifact, I
need
assure you.
Some better lighting here.
Princely sum. The champion was with the Emperor when he was slain by the cowardly assassins of the Mythic Dawn.
Mm.
Such a shame.
Right, the beginning of the Elder Scrolls IV.
The champion would never have risen to prominence. This
Guess
is
not.
The cuirass of Gavach. It's not the actual cuirass the champion was rewarded for services to the city.
It's not.
But it was touched by the champion when they brushed by a guardsman on the way in.
What?
Gavach was the first city saved by the champion during the Oblivion Crisis. They bravely entered the land of Daedra and broke the siege of the city. An ordinary piece of fabric.
Yeah, I was looking at that.
How could this be interesting? Must be a placeholder. Except it's not! The champion used this handkerchief to blow their nose while ascending to Cloud Ruler Temple.
Oh, God.
It was reclaimed by an old merchant during a trip to the ruins north of the city. Can you believe it? The essence of the champion! Preserved for us to see and touch!
That's quite right.
Touching the handkerchief is 50 septims. Would you like to touch the handkerchief?
Why would I want to touch that thing? What are we talking about? Hundreds years old boogers?
Because it's an artifact of the champion of Cyrodiil. Why else?
I am almost a millionaire. Sure, 50 gold.
There you go. Just touch it. Feel your hands caress it.
I don't want to caress it.
So, what do you think?
It's sticky.
Yes. From the records I've studied on the subject, the champion of Cyrodiil had a terrible case of rock joint at the time.
Caused
them to blow their nose constantly.
Ugh.
Anyway, let's move to the next display.
Good God. I gave him 50 septims for that. I must be as crazy as he is. Where are you going now?
Now this is a treat.
What, the fire?
The Sword of Bird.
Oh.
My family's progenitor. Bird was captain of the Bruma Guard and fought alongside the champion during the Battle of Bruma.
45 gold pieces.
Ever since, my family has taken the name Birdson to remember the great warrior from whom we stem. Touching the sword is 50 septims. Would you like to touch the sword?
Why would I want to touch a sword of all things?
Because it belonged to my great-great... grandfather. Captain Bird, of course.
Sure, I'll touch the sword if it makes you happy.
That's right. Feel your hand. Stroke the metal. Now, what did you think of that?
I got cut. Why not? It was the best sword I've ever stroked, and baby, I've stroked a lot of swords.
Thank you! I feel much the same way! Unless that was sarcasm?
Oh, no.
I never quite grasped that.
No, I assure
sword.
You.
I do a lot of sword grasping when I'm bored.
What?
Anyway, let's move to the next display.
Is this guy serious?
Finally, here we have my most prized possession. The Finger of the Champion.
Which
Many
one?
Many say the champion disappeared after
There's
the
There's at
crisis.
Least three.
But I know better. My theory is that the champion died following a great battle with a were-minotaur, a vampire, and a unicorn.
All at once?
Before the champion's body could be lost to the earth, it was carried away by woodland creatures at the behest of Kinnereth.
Okay.
Unfortunately, a band of Khajiit stole the body when it was being carried by a troop of squirrels. Before the body could be lost, an Argonian mercenary. Well, I won't bother you with the whole story. Just a theory of mine.
A theory.
However, if my theory is correct, then I have recovered one of the last parts of the body, the finger bone, and can present it to you today.
It looks like a whole
the
hand.
The display cases enclose other items that were owned by the champion. Swords, shields, brooches, silverware. All very exciting.
Hmm.
I also sell Champion's Vigor, a potion distilled from the herbs the champion was said to consume each morning. And you can have a portrait painted of you with the champion's finger. But you need to give a week's notice.
I hope you enjoyed the tour. Come back if you have any questions about the champion.
Okay. I will. Which finger was his?
Can I help you?
That's a whole hand, I think.
Hello?
I don't think I can take that. Yeah, that's a steal. I'll have to find another copy somewhere else. Can I look at some stuff down here?
It's time for you to go.
You don't see me. The dog, man.
Sorry, but you've got to go.
Okay. All right. All right. My bad.
What is it?
It's me going. You want a bed? Oh, can I take the book now?
You need to leave.
Can you see me?
Sorry, but you need to go. Now.
Wait, you can see me. It's this damn dog. Oh my god.
It's time for you to go.
It is time for me to go. It's time for me to find a home for this dog. I want that Bruma book, damn it. Oh god. Is this a cut above? Is this an inn? Just think, I could have stolen some bloody rags. Somebody's room? I thought this was a store. It's called a cut above, and there's like nothing here. Some private residence. You know who's seeing me? It's probably the dog seeing me. I have those books. It looks like whoever it is out. This is the noisiest dog. Gort?
Hello.
Hello, Gort.
My weapon wants a tempering. Things want a killing.
What?
Fetch me 3 iron ingots to temper my weapon and my book a killing so I know who needs killing. Then I'll give you gold.
Are you serious? And the rest of the voice acting was pretty good. Do you always greet people this way?
Only when my weapon wants a tempering and things want a killing.
Yeah, I think this is deadpan, like bad on purpose. I guess consider it done. You hang out at the Restful Watchman?
Good. My killing arm's itching to do more killing.
I'm sure it is. That's Gort's Book of Killing from... Alright, and 3 iron ingots?
Can I help you?
I don't think so, no. Is there anyone in here? The Restful Watchman? I'm sorry about the dog. I'm sorry.
Can I help you?
Pardon me?
Hello?
Aninril?
What is it?
Oh, you're a Bosmer? I can't even see you.
See you.
Well, I can't see you. I guess I can see you're a Bosmer. There's not many Bosmer in Bruma. Then again, I've been in Bruma for like 20 minutes.
No, there aren't. Doesn't matter much to me. But sometimes I do feel kind of isolated among all the Nords and Imperials.
I bet. Me even more than the Breton. What's brought you to Bruma?
There wasn't already an alchemist in town when I came up here, and I figured it was a burgeoning market and a ripe opportunity. Fortune favors the bold, or so they say.
Someone knocked me. So, okay, so you're an alchemist. How's business? Good enough, nothing to write home to Charl about, but it's a decent living. Okay.
No, there aren't. Doesn't matter much to me, but sometimes I do feel kind of isolated among all the Nords and Imperials. Can I help you?
Nope. Oh, Harold?
Farewell.
What is it?
From you here to do business?
Bye.
Can I go back and get that book then?
They call me Gort.
I'm sure they do. Of course, it's locked. That's why I had to leave. He wanted to leave to get his drink on.
Hello.
Hello?
Hmm?
I think he's like a construct.
Hello?
You're lonely, I can tell. Just eat your bread.
I'm not hopeful. If you have any cuts or bruises, I'd be happy to practice my restoration on you.
The prey approaches.
Hello?
Oh god, what a motley
group. The cold nips up here in the mountains, but I've always loved how refreshing it is.
Hmm?
Can I help you?
I feel like I'm being interrogated.
Can I help you?
Can I help you?
Hello?
Hello?
Hmm?
Hello? Hello?
What is it?
What is it?
Stop!
God. What is it?
Hello? What is it? they walked off, finally? Galarin, okay, hello. Apparently now we can talk in peace.
Can I help you?
So you're a mage? Specializing in restoration, then? Oh, goddamn,
yes,
that killed me.
I'm hoping to join the Synod Conclave here in Bruma.
Oh. Stupidest question ever, restoration.
Restoration mostly, but I also enjoy alchemy and alteration. Not so big on destruction. I like preserving life, not taking it.
Oh, I like destruction. So how did you end up in Bruma?
Oh, I was born in Bruma. I traveled around Cyrodiil and lived for a few years in Coral, but
Coral?
The mountains and the cold air always called to me.
Or Charl.
My parents used to say there must have been some Nord blood in our family for me to love the snow so much.
Mm.
There probably isn't, of course. My parents were from High Rock. That's about as Breton as it gets.
Yeah, I'm from High Rock.
Too bad they aren't here to see me make the Synod. I think they would have been proud.
Good man. I feel like an idiot asking these questions. Did something happen to your parents? Which, of course, we found out, yes.
They died a while back.
Huh?
Papa got sick, so Mama went out adventuring to try and raise money for a healer.
The dog's hovering.
Mama never made it back, so Papa never got his healing. I'm not broken up about it anymore. It happened several years ago now. But I do still miss the feeling of family. Of being loved, you know?
Absolutely.
In any case, being a mage of the Synod will help with that. That will be my place to belong.
So, hope everything works out. Born and raised in High Rock, and yeah, horrible things happened to my parents. Even worse, I'm not gonna pull that card, but yeah. Definitely know what you're talking about there.
Talk to you later.
I'll see you. Okay, well, I'll talk to you now.
To fail at a simple job like that.
What?
No way it was just a coincidence. It must have been. Oh, hello. What are you looking at? Speak.
You. You're looking at me. What were you mumbling about while you were looking at me?
That's none of your... I suppose there's no harm in telling you now. Who knows? Maybe you'll be able to help.
Probably.
I'm a mercenary. Been one for years now, and I don't often fail a job.
Until now?
But this last time, I did fail, but ding, ding. Not through any fault of my own.
Oh, sure, yeah. Let me guess, you need a hero to save the day?
Cut out the sarcasm. I don't appreciate it.
That's what I know.
If you want to help me, if you want the honor of working by my side, then you should at least exercise respect.
I've been hired
by some anonymous noble to clear out a cave full of bandits near Bruma. Offer some nice coin, too.
Mm.
My wife came with me. We're battle partners.
Ah, oh, sweet.
Things were going well until we were ambushed. Bandit reinforcements showed up out of nowhere, flanking us the way we came. They bound us and gagged us, left us disarmed and defeated.
Damn.
They left with my wife and left me to die.
Oh no.
I managed to escape my captivity, but when I got back to the cave, they'd gone. All of them. Including my wife.
Well, you said they left
with her. Searching for her damn near a whole year now. No success.
I'd like to help now that his wife is kidnapped. You said you'd be getting a hefty sum. I don't suppose there'd be pay involved? Maybe some cut of that?
A mercenary, eh? Someone after my own heart. Sure there'd be. I have a bit of coin left over from the old days.
That's right. He wouldn't get paid for that job. It's been too long. Yeah, I'll help you.
Praise Malakath. Once you turn up something solid, let me know. I'll be here. The best place to start is probably the castle. Ask the nobles. See if they know anything.
Ugly love.
What are you doing gawking at me? Shoo! I've given you a task.
What can I do for you?
Found the culprit.
Don't talk to me like that. Beg your pardon. Oh, okay. Poof.
Can I help you?
He went poof. Okay.
Oh, hello.
I can't move. Hmm? Damn, dog. Carlia, help me.
Please make it brief. We have much to do.
Oh, God.
Good.
Hi. The awful striking eyes. Is that... You're the one?
Can I help you?
Yeah. What could they want with your wife?
I wish I knew. Actually... No, I'm glad I don't.
You're next.
I don't want to think about it. It can't be good.
What makes you so sure this was a setup?
We'd made it far, and done the job expertly. There were only a few bandits left. Then, suddenly, we're ambushed from behind, knocked to the floor, and restrained like dogs. I know coincidences, and this certainly wasn't one. Too meticulous, too perfect, too pre-planned.
Speaking of dogs, I'd do it for free if you'll take this dog off my hands. How were you hired if you don't know the noble's identity?
Because the job came down the chain of power. I didn't get it directly from whoever ordered it. The steward gave me the job, but the steward gives out all the jobs. I doubt he even knows where the order came down from.
Alright, well, I'll look into that.
Talk to you later.
Where'd the Argonian go off to?
Hello.
Oh, you're a ninja. I didn't even see you. Crouches in crevices?
Can I help you? Hello.
Okay, you don't speak. Oh, the Song of Pelennel. A rising threat. Dog pushing me. God damn.
What is it?
It's this dog. Oh, Bentior? Can I talk to you, Bentior? Heard any rumors lately?
A little birdie told me that you're annoying me.
What? You get much trouble in here?
Seems to me you're starting trouble asking questions like that. This is a fine establishment. We don't pretend to be more than we are, though. Now, what can I get you?
Do you ever run into trouble given your tavern's shady reputation? Watch him go off now.
Well, honestly, sometimes I do. I'm only saying this because I suspect you might be able to help me out.
That's a surprise.
You see, there's this snooty Altmer that came through here a few days back. One of those haughty Alinor types. Newcomer to Bruma.
Huh.
Well, he came here, not realizing that the Geral view might have been more to his tastes.
Hmm.
After he witnessed a few of our, morally gray activities and an exceptional display of promiscuity, well, he decided to leave.
Well, that's good.
Now, in his outrage and disgust, he's planning to try and press charges against my tavern.
Oh, that's bad.
If you could just talk him down, I'd appreciate it.
Hmm. Given how rude you were being, why exactly should I help you?
Because I can pay you, and I'm just too charming to resist.
Oh, sure.
Why wouldn't you help me?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Great. He's probably storming around town right now, trying to rabble-rouse against the Watchman. Put a stop to it.
Please. Got any food and drink around here?
Here's what I have.
Ooh. Mud crab stew. Garlic carrots? That actually sounds really good. Yeah. Rice bread? Salmon stew. Venison pasty? Ooh. I'll have a venison pasty and some greenwood meat. Just one. Oh, sir.
See you.
Pretty expensive stuff. Yeah. I have butter. Nom nom. Go, go, go. I was gonna help myself see what's up here. Oh, these are tiny little tables. Oh, no. Whoa. No. No! God damn. Dog! Jesus! This dog has to go.
The prey approaches.
The prey's on the way out the door.
Gort's the name, killing's the game.
God, this dog. What was Annenreel's house? Boltrim the Hammer's house? Why is this late? All these places are closed. Welcome to my humble stall. What do you wish to buy? Oh my god. Someone! Anyone! Take a dog. The Cathedral of St. Martin. You know what? Gonna call it an episode here, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Stay tuned for next episode when we go into the Cathedral of St. Martin and check out some more of the city of Bruma. Thanks so much for watching, and always, seek adventure.